Hello. Happy Monday after Easter. Today is our final lesson in our Holy Week lessons. And so our song is going to be This is Amazing Grace, and we've already sung that. So the lyrics are already on Facebook. And the only thing you need is to have a room divided like we did earlier, because I'm going to give you choices to make, and you'll go to either side of the room based on your choice. So, first I want to ask you about a surprise. Do you like surprises? You do? A lot of us do. If I surprised you with pizza, that'd be a good surprise. If I surprised you with a test, probably not. So it depends on what the surprise is, right? Well, I'm going to give you two surprises, and you're going to pick which one you like best, okay? So the first choice, you're the right side. The choice is, when this whole thing's over and we can like do things again, your parents say that you're gonna go to an amusement park. That's choice one. Or choice two is you're gonna take a vacation to the beach. Which are you gonna pick? Okay, I'd probably pick the beach vacation. Okay, what if the surprises were school's gonna open back up, or you have to repeat the same grade that you were in? Yeah, I want school to open up. I don't want to have to repeat the same. That'd be sad for my kids. That was a April Fool's prank on Facebook. It wasn't very funny. Okay, tomorrow for dessert, your mom's either going to surprise you with a banana splits or homemade cookies. Which one are you going to pick? I'd probably pick the homemade cookies. Okay. What if someone was to surprise you either with a new bike or a new video game? Oh, okay. I'd probably pick the bike. So surprises a lot of times are good. But like if you jump out of my room when I'm sleeping and scream, that would not be a pleasant surprise. So we're at a really cool part of the big story that God's told in the Bible. But before we get to today's lesson, we're going to review our Holy Week lessons that we've had so far. So first, last Sunday, on Palm Sunday, we remember that Jesus came into Jerusalem and was greeted as a king, right? They put palm branches and cloaks down in his path. They greeted him as a king. And then on Maundy Thursday, we learned about the Last Supper, where they gathered for their Passover meal. And remember, Jesus showed by example how to serve one another. Do you remember what he did? Exactly. He got on his knees and he washed their feet to show that you are to serve one another. And then he told them as he broke the bread and poured the cup that they were going to remember his body and his blood every time they had that meal. And that's why we had communion during the Good Friday service. Speaking of Good Friday, that was the time that Jesus was crucified on the cross. And after he was dead, they buried him in a new tomb in the garden. But we know that Jesus isn't in that tomb because Mary, that same day, Mary and the other Mary went to the tomb, and Jesus was not there, but he did appear to Mary. And then last night, we learned about the walk to Emmaus when Jesus was walking with two of his believers, and he kept them from being able to recognize him. And he taught them how all of Scripture points to him. And they didn't realize that it was Jesus until they were sitting at the table. And do you remember what happened when they figured it out? Right, they hightailed it to Jerusalem to let the disciples know. So today's story is called Jesus Appeared to the Disciples. So I want you to imagine what it would have been like after the crucifixion. People were mad. People were mad about Jesus. That's why they crucified him. So on this first day of the week, the disciples had gathered together in a house, and they locked the doors because they were afraid of the Jews, because the Jews were not happy with the followers of Jesus, and they didn't want the Jews to come and get them and to kill them like they had killed Jesus. But wait, Jesus had already appeared to two disciples on the road to Emmaus, and he had appeared to Mary Magdalene. And so they had all these reports that Jesus was alive, but they still wonder, is it true? Well, as the disciples were talking among themselves, Jesus comes and stands among them. And he says, "Peace to you." The disciples were afraid. They couldn't believe their eyes. Was this really Jesus? The disciples thought they were seeing a ghost. And Jesus says, "Why are you afraid? It's me. Why do you doubt? Look at me. Touch me. A ghost doesn't have flesh and bones, but I do." So Jesus showed his disciples his hands and his side. So they saw the holes in his hands where the nails had been, and they saw the hole in his side where the spear had gone. Jesus was alive. It seemed too good to be true. The disciples rejoiced because they were so happy to see Jesus. The disciples gave him some fish to eat. And Jesus talked to them, and he explained how the Bible all pointed to Jesus and was all about Jesus. He taught them how to understand that the law of Moses and the prophets and the Psalms were all about Jesus. And then Jesus told the disciples that they had a big job to do. Jesus had died and was raised from the dead, so that people could be forgiven for their sins. The disciples needed to tell other people to repent from their sin so that they could be forgiven too. "Peace to you," he said again. "God sent me to earth, and in the same way, I am sending you." So Jesus sent out his disciples to be his witnesses and to tell all the people that he was alive. And in those 40 days after Jesus rose from the dead, he presented himself to at least 500 people who serve as witnesses that all this had happened. I mean, that's just amazing. Jesus had the power to defeat death. He didn't just give the disciples a job to do on their own power. He gave them the power through the Holy Spirit so that they could go to all the worlds and tell them that Jesus is alive. And Jesus is still alive. As Christians, our job is to tell other people that Jesus died on the cross, but that he's not dead anymore, and that they can become his follower. Only God can change a person's heart. Only Jesus can save. But God can use us to tell people about Jesus. So that's your challenge. Your challenge is to tell other people about Jesus. Now we've been learning about the Dye family. And do you remember where the Dye family lives? Right, they live in Atlanta, Georgia. And they pray for the people of Atlanta that they would have the chance to tell them about Jesus. Well, just like Jesus told his disciples to tell people about the gospel, he tells us to do that too. So I want you to think about your home and your family, your friends at school, the neighborhood where you live, all those people that you see or know. And I want you to think of somebody that you can tell about Jesus. Now, one thing that the Dyes do is they invite people to their church, the M28 Church. Well, and you can do that too. I mean, right now you can invite them to watch church online, but when this is over and we get to gather back in our church building again, then you could invite someone to come to church with you and to learn in your Sunday school class or back in Disciple Town about Jesus. So I want you to think about that person that you can talk to. And I want you to think about what you could tell them about Jesus. And I'm going to pray for the Dyes and for the missionaries our church supports. And I'm going to pray for you and me that we'll have the courage to tell somebody else about Jesus. So let's pray. Father God, we come before you, Lord, and we pray your blessing on missionaries all around the world. People who have devoted their lives to take your gospel to all of the nations and baptizing them in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. But Father, we pray specifically for the Dyes as they serve you in Atlanta. We ask that you would bless their efforts and that you would use their devotion as a way to call people to yourself. We continue to pray for the Newells and Darby and the Efflers and the Westbrooks, that you would bless their mission work and that you would use them to make a difference in the neighborhoods and in the countries where you have placed them. And Father, I pray for the boys and girls listening to this lesson, that you would help them to have the courage to invite their friends to church or to tell their friends that Jesus loves them. Help them to tell their aunts and their uncles that Jesus loves them and wants to be their Savior and Lord. And Father, we pray for Melissa and JC and their kids as they continue to prepare to move to Africa and to begin the work that you have called them to do. We ask that you would work together all things for their good and your glory. And we ask you this in your precious Son's name. Amen. Okay, now let's sing a song. And we've already sang this song, but that's okay. We're going to sing it again. Because let's face it, His grace is still amazing.
Breaks the power of sin and darkness, whose love is mighty and so much stronger, the King of glory, the King above all kings. Who takes the whole earth with holy thunder, who leaves us breathless in awe and wonder, the King of glory, the King above all kings. This is amazing grace. This is unfailing love, that you would take my place, that you would bear my cross. You laid down your life that I would be set free. Oh, Jesus, I sing for all that you've done for me. Who brings the chaos back into order, who makes the orphan a son and daughter, the King of glory, the King of glory, who rules the nations with truth and justice, shines like the sun in all of its brilliance, the King of glory, the King above all kings. This is amazing grace. This is unfailing love, that you would take my place, that you would bear my cross. You laid down your life that I would be set free. Jesus, I sing for all that you've done for me. Worthy is the Lamb who was slain. Worthy is the King who conquered the grave. Worthy is the Lamb who was slain. Worthy is the King who conquered the grave. Worthy is the Lamb who was slain. Worthy is the King who conquered the grave. Worthy is the Lamb who was slain. Worthy, worthy, worthy. Yeah, this is amazing grace. This is unchailing love. That you would take my place. That you would bear my cross. You laid down your life. That I would be set free. Oh, Jesus, I sing for all that you've done for me. All that you've done for me.
His grace is amazing. No way around it. Alrighty, so today our Show What You Know is going to be a biggie. I'm going to ask you questions from the whole Holy Week lesson, okay? What did Jesus ride going into Jerusalem on what we call Palm Sunday? Yeah, he rode the donkey just like the scripture said he would. When he was eating dinner with the disciples, what did he do after the food was on the table? Before they ate? Yeah, Jesus, the Son of God, washed their feet to show them how to serve others. Let's see, who betrayed Jesus by kissing him so that the guards would know who Jesus was? Yeah, Judas. Who else was crucified that day? Two criminals. The tomb, was it an old one or a new one? Yeah, it was a tomb where no one else had ever been buried. Why did they put the big old rock in front of the tomb? Yes, they were afraid that someone would come and steal the body of Jesus. How many days was Jesus dead before he rose from the dead? Three. Yeah. Who came to the tomb early Sunday morning and found the stone opened? Right, the Marys did. Do you remember which disciples ran to the tomb to check? Peter and John, right. So where were the guys heading that Jesus didn't reveal himself to? He was with them and talking, but kept them from knowing who he was. Do you remember where they were going? Right, they were going to Emmaus. And when Jesus allowed their eyes to be open for them to recognize who he was, and Jesus then left, what did those two disciples do? Right, they hightailed it back to Jerusalem to tell the other disciples. So, when Jesus appeared in today's story to the disciples, what did they think he was? Right, they thought he was a ghost. So how did Jesus prove that he wasn't a ghost? Exactly. He said, look, here's my hands, here's my side, touch it, see it. I was stabbed with a spear. I was nailed to the cross. So what job did Jesus give the disciples to do? Right, they were to tell people the news about Jesus' death and resurrection. Now this one's going to get a little tougher because it's about you. Who is one person, whether it's someone you go to school with, someone in your neighborhood, or someone in your family, who is one person that you could tell about Jesus or invite to church? I want you to think of who that person is, and I want you to talk to your parents about it so maybe they can help you figure out a way to share the gospel with them and then to invite them to go to church once we can go back to the church building again. So what is something that you would tell that person about Jesus? Tell them that he's God's son and that he died for them. So when you're trying to tell somebody about Jesus, how do you feel inside? Sometimes we get nervous, right? Just like the disciples were scared before Jesus showed up. They were scared about how the Jews would treat them, how they would react. Sometimes we get scared about how someone will react if we tell them about Jesus. But Jesus gives us the Holy Spirit to help us. So we are called to go make disciples, just like Jesus told the disciples. And we can use this Bible verse to help us. If you confess with your mouth that Jesus is Lord and believe in your heart that God raised him from the dead, you will be saved. Well, to conclude our final lesson of Holy Week, I want us to pray. Father God, we thank you so much for sending your son Jesus to die on the cross for our sin. And we praise you because you have power over death and you raised Jesus to life again on that third day, just like you promised in Old Testament scriptures. Help us to share this amazing news with the people that we know that don't know you. Help us to have courage and to have a peace that surpasses understanding. We ask you this in your precious son's name. Amen. Well, that's it. The last lesson for Holy Week. We will have our regular scheduled Sunday school lesson next Sunday at 9 o'clock. See you there.